गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ किरणदीप कौर. टुडे आई एम हेयर विद द सेम टॉपिक, दैट इज चैप्टर 11, मेजरमेंट ऑफ वेट. बिकॉज देर आर सम मिस्टेक्स इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज द मेजरमेंट ऑफ वेट. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दैट हाउ वी कैन मेजर द वेट ऑफ द डिफरेंट थिंग्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, देर आर टू थिंग्स इन माई हैंड. First one is the stone and second one is the marker. You can easily say that stone is heavier than the marker. But if there are two markers in my hand, how can you say that which one is the heavier and which one is the lighter? By using this beam balance, we can measure the weight. Students, some commonly used weights are 500 gram, 1 kg, 2 kg and 5 kg. These are the higher weights that we can use to measure the things. Students, the heavier side of an object go towards the downward direction and the lighter side of the object goes towards the upward direction. For example, students, in the first sum, you have to take the pan which is lighter. Take the pan which is lighter. Now there are two pens. Which one is the lighter? The pen which is on the upward direction, that is lighter, and the pen which is on the downward direction, heavier. For example, in the first sum, in the first pen there is some weight and in the second pen there is a T, and the T pen is on the upward direction and the weight is on the downward direction. Now here you have to take the lighter pen. Now tell me, which one is the lighter? The lighter one goes towards the upward direction, so T is the lighter pen. In the same way, you have to solve the second part. Students, second sum. Second sum is, take the pen which is heavier. Here you have to take the pen which is heavier. Two pens are given. In the one pen there is some weight and in the another pen there is a can of milk or whatever. Students, here you have to take the heavier pen. Now the heavier object goes towards the downward direction. Now tell me, from these two pens, which one is on the downward direction? The second pen that having a can containing can, that means this side is the heavier side. Students, next, when the beam is balanced, that means when the both pens are on the same direction. For example, here the pens are on the same. These pens are balanced. That means the weight on both the pens are equal. In the third sum, you have to find the weight of the following. Students, let us understand with the help of an example. First of all, see this flashcard. Students, pens are balanced and in the first pen there is weight, that is 5 kg, and in the second pen there are grapes. That means the weight of the grapes is 5 kg, because the pen is beam balance is balanced. So in the first sum there is some weight and on the weight quantity is given, that is 500 gram, and in the second pen there are some grapes. Now what is the weight of the grapes? That is the 500 gram is the weight of the grapes. Next student, fourth part, how much these vegetables weigh? Students, vegetable weight is given. A cauliflower weight is 250 gram. Next one, carrot weight is 100 gram. Next one, onion weight is 50 gram. Next one, brinjals weight is 100 gram. and the last one, that is chilies. The chilies weight is 20 gram. Students, in the first sum, you have to find out the weight of the 8 brinjals. First sum, that is 8 brinjals. What is the weight of 1 brinjal? That is 100 gram. Then how can we find out the weight of 8 brinjals multiplying by weight? So 8 multiply weight of brinjals is 100 gram. That means 800 gram. This is the answer. Students, in the second sum, you have to find out the weight of 4 cauliflowers. Second sum, 4 cauliflowers. Now, what is the weight of the 1 cauliflower? That is 250 gram. And how can we find out the weight of 4 cauliflowers multiplying by 250? Multiply by 250 gram. Now multiply 4 by 250, you will get 1000 gram. Students, next, fifth sum is, you have to find out the weight of 2 brinjals and 3 cauliflowers. Fifth sum, 2 brinjals and 3 cauliflowers. How? First of all, 2 brinjals are there. What is the weight of brinjal? 100 grams. So, multiplied by 100. After that, add. 3 cauliflowers are there. What is the weight of the cauliflower? 250. 3 multiplied by 250 gram. Now, 2 multiplied by 100 becomes 200 plus 3 multiplied by 250, 750 grams. That means the answer is 950 grams. In this way, you can solve the other sum. In the next sum, 5 onions and 6 chilies are there. In the next sum, 5 onions and 6 chilies. Now, what is the weight of the onions? That is 50 gram. So, 5 multiplied by 50 gram. Plus, what is the weight of 6 chilies? 1 chili is 20 gram. So, 6 multiplied by 20 gram. It becomes 250 gram plus 120 gram. After addition, you will get the answer. Students, now let's solve the next exercise 11.2. In this exercise, you are going to add and subtract the weight. Statements are given. For example, first one is 25, first part, plus 66. Now students, first of all, start adding from the right hand side. 5 plus 6 becomes 11, so 11. This one right hand on this side, and this one shifted toward here. Now, 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 6, 91. This is the answer. Next one is 46 plus 37. Now students, again start addition from the right hand side. 6 plus 7, 13. Now, 3 comes here and 1 on the left hand side. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 3, 8. That means 83 is the answer. Now students, next sum is when 3 statements are given and how you can add these one. 17, 39 and 11. First of all, add the right hand side. 9 plus 1, 10 plus 7, 17. So write down here. 7, write down here. And 1 shifted to that side. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. That means 67 is the answer. Students, now let's do the subtraction sums. Minus 18. Students, again, subtraction also start from the right hand side. 5 minus 8. Students, how you can subtract? 5 is the lesser term and 8 is the greater term. So, take borrow. Here, cut 6 and 1 write down on the left hand side of the 5. It becomes the 15. 15 minus 8, 7. 6 minus 1, 5. That is the answer. Students, in this sum, 5 is less than 8. So, we can take borrow from the left hand side. Here, it becomes the 6 and 1 on the left hand side of 5. It becomes 15. 15 minus 8 becomes 7 and 6 minus 1 becomes 5. Students, let us solve one more sum for subtraction so that you can understand. 36 minus 27. Students, here again, 6 is lesser and the 7 is greater. So, take borrow from the left hand side. 1, it becomes 2 and 1 on that side. It becomes 16. 16 minus 7 becomes 9 and 2 minus 2, 0. That means 9 is the answer. Students, your homework is to solve the other sum of addition and subtraction and exercise 11.1 with the help of your parents on your fair notebooks. Thank you.